Welcome to Dalit Knowledge. Dalit Knowledge is the knowledge of the truth. This is Professor Dr. Leela Karunikaran, Dalit historian and an Ambedkarite thinker. The title of this lecture is Kanshi Ram's question on caste. What is that question? Kanshi Ram attended first Dalit International Conference held at Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia in 1998, addressing the Dalit delegates who came from different parts of the world. In the first Dalit International Conference, Kanshi Ram raised very, very important question that gives a clear direction to the Dalit agenda. What was that question Kanshi Ram raised in that first Dalit International Conference? Manyavar Kanshi Ram questioned caste loving people that if you love so much your caste, how can you destroy the caste system which is destroying you? There are millions of Dalit people who leave their villages and migrate to big cities. These people do not bring anything with them. The only thing they bring with them is their caste. They leave behind in the villages their small huts, a small plot of land, etc. But they can't leave behind their caste in the village. The caste invariably accompanies them to the cities where they begin to stay in dirty shanties along the side of railway tracks and nallas. The caste is so dear to the people, then how can we destroy the caste system? This is the question Kanshi Ram raised about 20 years back. But still, this question has relevance and it needs proper attention from the Dalit intellectual class. To address the question raised by Kanshi Ram, first we need to understand the intensity of the question. Suppose you love something so much, how can you leave it? If you love smoking, it is not so easy to leave smoking, though you know that smoking is injurious to your health. Like slow poison, smoking eats your body parts and finally it kills you. Even after knowing that smoking kills you, you don't leave smoking because you love smoking. As long as you love smoking, you don't quit smoking. Same is the case with love for your caste. Caste system kills you, destroys you. In the caste system, you are not getting self-respect, dignity, and opportunities. You are humiliated day and night because of the caste. Sometimes you feel to quit life instead of quitting the caste. You know very well that the root cause of most of your problems is caste. You don't know how to face caste discrimination because you don't know how to destroy the caste. You don't even think to destroy the caste, though it is destroying you, because you love caste. It is very interesting to note that you want to destroy caste on one hand and you want to love caste on the other hand. How could it possible to destroy caste when you are in love with the caste? To destroy caste, first you need to hate caste. You need to hate your caste to destroy the caste system. The question is how to form a casteless Dalit society? How to make Dalit race casteless? How to liberate the Dalit community from the caste clutches? The primary aim of Dalitism is to form a casteless Dalit society. What should we do to form a casteless Dalit society? Caste creates selfish interest, particularly among Dalits. Without destroying the selfish interest, we can't destroy the caste. The biggest loser in the caste system is Dalit. Casteism within the caste gives a kind of artificial feeling of togetherness, but practically caste works only when you encounter other caste people. Otherwise, caste divides caste into many subcastes. In fact, the basic nature of caste is division. It keeps on dividing people into smaller social groups. Any kind of unity is not acceptable to caste. Even unity of the same caste doesn't work in normal circumstances. In other words, unless one caste encounters another caste, no caste produces unity within the caste. No caste produces unity within the caste group. Hence, superficial caste benefits actually create selfish interests. People use caste identity for their personal gains and to fulfill selfish interests and not for group interests. Look at some leaders who use caste to mobilize their caste people for political and economic gains, but keep the whole caste in backwards. They use caste identity only to gain personal benefits and not for the benefit of the whole caste. It is so because the idea called caste feeling is actually casteism, and casteism in fact works against group interest because caste knows no unity, only division. Hence, casteism is a tool in the hands of scoundrels to make short-term gains. This is also the case with many castes within the Dalit race. Hence, the first and foremost important thing is that caste creates only selfish interest. Selfish interest is casteism, and to destroy the caste, first we need to destroy caste generated selfish interest. This selfish interest needs to be destroyed at any cost. It means once casteism is destroyed, caste is destroyed. Dalits are not the creators of caste. If Dalits did not create caste, then who created caste? Aryans created Varna. Ambedkar said Varna is the mother of caste. In other words, caste is born out of the Varna system created by Aryans. History says that the Brahmin race is the biggest beneficiary of the caste system. How and why? Varna system, the mother of the caste system, gives the highest status to Brahmin race within the Aryan ideological society. Hence, the Brahmin race is the biggest beneficiary of the caste system, though it is also divided into many castes and subcastes. The source of the caste system, that is Varna system, is designed to give more benefits to Brahmin race, and caste system operates within the broader ideological world of Varna system. Brahmin race enjoys all benefits even in the caste system. because it belongs to Aryan Varna ideological world. Hence, though the Brahmin race is divided into many castes, it knows how to overcome its caste divisions and how to take advantage of caste divisions in other races. Dalit race is also divided into many castes and subcastes. Unlike Brahmin race, Dalit race unable to overcome caste divisions within it, and it has become the victim of caste divisions. Since the Varna caste system is alien to Dalit ideological world, the Dalit race has become the biggest victim. Since the Varna caste system is organic to the Aryan ideological world, the Brahmin race has become the biggest beneficiary of the caste system. The generation after generation, Dalit race has been at the receiving end of this oppressive caste system. The Dalit race has been subjected to the beastly oppression and inhuman humiliations. Why would the beneficiaries of Varna caste system destroy it? It is the duty of the victim to destroy the Varna caste system. Hence, the annihilation of the Varna caste system is the duty of the Dalit race. But it doesn't mean that Dalit race has to waste its time and energy to destroy Varna caste in the other races. Annihilation of Varna caste outside Dalit race is not the duty of Dalits. In other words, it is not the duty of Dalit race to destroy Varna caste in Brahmin race or in Shudra race. Let the Shudras destroy Varna caste in Shudra race. Let the Brahmins destroy Varna caste in Brahmin race. It is the divine duty of every Dalit to annihilate Varna caste within the Dalit race. There are more than 1000 castes in Dalit race. Annihilation of caste within the Dalit race unites Dalits into one race and one community. United Dalit race is stronger than the divided Dalit race. United Dalit race can fight against racial discrimination, which is known in India as casteism. How to create a united Dalit race? That's the most important question before us. Marriage within the Dalit race but not within the caste creates united Dalit race. Say no to same caste marriage. Marriage outside the caste but in the race creates a unified strong Dalit race. I have married outside the caste in which I have born, but within the Dalit race. That strengthens, empowers Dalit race. Chamar should marry Pasis. Pasis should marry Chamars. Bangis should marry Pasis. Pasis should marry Bangis. Bangis should marry Chamars. Chamars should marry Bangis. Mahars should marry Mans. Chambars should marry Mahars. Madhiga should marry Malas. Malas should marry Madhigas. Paryas should marry Pallans. Pallans should marry Paryas. There are more than 1000 castes within the Dalit race. If there are marriages within the Dalit race, not within the caste, then Dalit race will become very strong and empowered Dalit community. Only inter-caste marriages within the Dalit race can destroy caste and casteism and makes Dalit race very strong, dynamic, progressive, socially, economically and politically highly empowered race. If you really listening to the Kanshiram words, if you are really sincere to the question raised by Kanshiram, that if you love caste, how can you destroy the caste? Don't love caste. Destroy the caste. To destroy the caste, first you have to hate the caste. If you hate caste, you don't marry within your caste. Tell your parents, tell your brothers, tell your sisters. The one and only way to make ourselves very powerful, very strong socially and economically, there is the only one way, that is marriages within the Dalit race, but not marriages within the same caste. I am not against Dalits marrying non-Dalits. After all, love and marriage are personal choices. But for the sake of Dalit unity, to make Dalits more powerful, we need to have marriages within the Dalit race. For the sake of Dalit unity, to make Dalit community more powerful, we should not marry within the same caste. I hope the followers of Manyavar Kanshi Ram and followers of Baba Saheb Ambedkar take this question of Kanshi Ram, that if you love caste, how can you destroy the caste? Your marriage within the same caste means you are loving the caste. Jai Bhim, Jai Bharat. Thank you very much.